As an adolescent, I remember spending my teenage years mostly being either tongue-tied or shy or moody and angry. A large part of those painful years, however, was spent being hopelessly mortified at everything around me. The old Fiat car my father drove, which kept breaking down at awkward intervals. My sister laughing loudly in movie halls. My parents actually going to meet my teachers at school. Or me developing a football-sized tie in my eye on the day of my cousin's wedding. However, as we grow up, we learn to see things in proportion and in balance and as they really are. However, this fact seems to have missed the female brain completely because it continues suffering from heightened anxious brain syndrome despite moving deep into adulthood. What else can explain our particular penchant for always seeing the negative in ourselves rather than the positives? For concentrating on criticism rather than praise? For seeing all flaws magnified manifold in ourselves and thus remaining acutely anxious most of the time? Most certainly, I see a wide disparity in self-confidence between the male and female managers who worked under me. A female manager will come out of a presentation and immediately start muttering about all the things she did wrong. She will filter out all the positives and retain only the mistakes she made. While the male manager usually swaggers out of such meetings, assured that he's just delivered the Gettysburg Address. The fact is, we are all a cocktail of strengths and weaknesses, strong and weak points. We just need to learn to see both with an unjaundiced eye. There is absolutely no need to catastrophize weaknesses, whether in ourselves or the startup we are launching. Life is always about the middle ground. Building on strengths and working at minimizing weaknesses is a constant endeavor. Even our own prejudices about ourselves should not be allowed to come in the way of marching ahead. I've witnessed what focusing on strengths instead of weaknesses can do to a woman's life. And I've intimately experienced how doing the opposite hurts. The sty is never as large as it seems. And more notably, it is temporary. Regardless of that, you have beautiful eyes. Make the most of them. A little Kajal, perhaps?